Hi and welcome to my channel, or welcome back. So if you have been on BookTok or Bookstagram in the last few months or a year, you probably have heard about this book called The Octonomy. I've put the book into the original packaging so I can show it to you again on camera, and I'll be doing a review of this book today. When I first heard about this book, there was so much mystery surrounding it. Like, people were just posting reviews about how great it is, but nobody really told me like what to expect. So hopefully I would do that today in this video for you if you're interested in this book. First, let me tell you about how you can actually get this book yourself. So back in May, when I became interested in this book, you could only buy it off their official website. Now they have partnered up with a US company, so it seems like the shipping to the US seems to be easier. I don't know if this will affect shipping to other countries or not. They claim that it doesn't, but I don't know. One thing that I do need to mention is that when I bought it, the book was roughly £20, which is about $26, and now it's $35, so they have bumped up the price quite a bit actually. They always put out new editions of the book. It's the same book, it just has like a bunch of different pages, a bunch of different AR content that they're trying to push out. And I'll talk about this in a second. My edition is the waiting list edition, and now the new edition has an extra letter or something. Okay, let's just jump right into the unboxing. So this is the box. It's already opened, obviously. I've opened this back in May. So when you open it, as you can see, there's this welcome home tag, which looks really cool. So with the book, and I think this was in every edition, you get a little postcard. It's reflecting a lot. There you go. You also get a pronunciation guide and like different definitions of the world as well. Let me show it to you. And trust me, you will definitely need this, like, once you start reading. Here is the actual book. There you go. It is a paperback. They don't really offer hardbacks or ebooks, I think. Looks very beautiful. The black pages look very cool. This book is written by Trevor Allan Forrest, and I think it is a pen name. I'm not exactly sure. There's supposed to be 12 books in the series, which is crazy. I'll talk about this at the end of the video. They have introduced a bonus AR content. You can download an app onto your phone, and the pages basically come alive, which is very cool. It is basically about a secret society, and I have to say, like, the marketing of this book was really excellent, because especially before, when you first order it, you kind of feel like you're ordering something that you shouldn't be, and it's so secretive and it makes you feel special. And now I feel like they sort of ruined the magic when they partner up with a different website, but that's just my personal opinion. Now let's jump into the actual review and what this book is about, because that's the most important part, right? I know that some people in their reviews were stating that it's very original, it's very different, but I was just like, how different it is. You follow twins. Their names are Tred and Rig, I think. I'm gonna be honest, I messed up the names a lot because they are impossible to read. The twins live in this utopia dimension, I think that's what it is, called Tyrolen, and you cannot die in this world. Basically, your body can, but your conscience doesn't. So you can live as many lives as you can until your body just stops regenerating at some point, which usually doesn't happen too early. The people in it basically have magic abilities. Some of them can read minds. You can also materialize everything from thin air. You can move stuff with your mind. Like, it's very utopic. Very early on, you learn that a crime has been committed some time ago. It doesn't necessarily say when, I think. And then two people enter this world, even though they shouldn't, and just a bunch of weird stuff starts happening, and That's it, you go from there. The book is told from a perspective of all-knowing conscience. His job is to write everything that happens, and his name is Trevor, like the author. Now, the problem is that nothing is really explained to you. You're just thrown into this world, and it makes sense because why would this voice explain stuff to the characters that already know everything, right? So you're just thrown into it. And I'm gonna be honest, I was pretty confused for at least like 150 pages. Then I started to kind of get the gist of it, how it works. But I've seen on some reviews on Goodreads that people just didn't really get the world at all. So I'll do my best to explain it to you if you're interested, because I wish somebody would have explained this to me when I first started. So the way this works is that there are different dimensions. They are called Innosummits. I think that's how you pronounce it. I might be wrong. And they are basically like layers. You cannot travel through them however you want because there are different access points, basically like travel points, and the majority of them are controlled by the Octonomy, which to my understanding is an organization that is supposed to protect the peace. One of the dimensions is also our world, and it's called Fethrist. Trust me, you will be very less confused if you know this information. There is a excessive world building in this book, and when I say excessive, I truly mean it. It almost reminds me of Alice in the Wonderland, when you just meet a new character each chapter and just weird stuff start to happen, and then you move on to the next character and you might not even meet the first character anymore in the story. That's very much how this book is based like, especially in the first two-thirds of the story. You always meet new characters, always weird stuff start to happen, and you might be confused. But I actually really enjoyed the confusion and I just went with it, and I actually had a really good time reading this book. And it was fun, like this book genuinely is fun. It's definitely not your typical fantasy novel, and if you are an avid fantasy reader like me and you sometimes can get bored a little of the genre, I would highly recommend this book for you actually. The best way I could describe this book is crime solving in the Wonderland. One thing that I also need to mention is that the characters are constantly bickering with each other, but I didn't mind it. I find it quite humorous. This book was written by a UK author and you can definitely see the British humor in it, but I like British humor, so it was actually very fun for me. Also, you can truly tell the environmental and humanitarian views of the author in this book. But it's not really excessive, it doesn't disturb the story. I feel like sometimes with books, the authors just kind of force these ideas down your throat, but it wasn't the case like this with this book. Like, everything just flows nicely, and actually a lot of the ideas make sense in this world. I really loved this book, I gave it 5 stars. But now let's talk about the negatives, because there are a few. So number one is that sometimes women are just very weirdly described. There is even this weird scene where a woman is just described in a very offensive way, I would say, even because like her body was jiggling or something like that. I don't even want to say it, it was so weird. And then she even apologizes to the men in the room for being a distraction, for simply existing. Please, can we not do that? It's just, it's a no from me, okay? And then the second negative thing is that this book was published in like January 1st, 2019. I looked up the original publishing date. And so far there are absolutely no updates on book 2. And this series is supposed to have 12 books in total. So imagine, it's already going to be 2022 very soon. If one book would take 3 years to be published, that's about 36 years in total. And I would be over 60 by the time this series would be published. Which, is insane. Like, not only it gave me an existential crisis when I thought about it, I probably will lose interest at some point during those years. To me, it seems like they're really trying to capitalize on the hype right now, and just they're publishing constantly like different editions, different bonus content, but they're not really focusing on what's actually important, which is the next book in the series. I'm sort of expecting them to just release the book 2 out of nowhere, just like they did with the first book, but let's see. If book 2 will come out soon, I will probably still buy it, even though it will be probably more expensive than the first one, because I really enjoyed the story. But if it would take years and years for the books to come out, I'll probably just lose interest. And I'm saying this as a person who absolutely loved this book. Alright, so that's it really. I don't know if you noticed, but I dressed up to match the book cover a little bit. I feel like I need a hat, because everybody in this book was constantly wearing a hat. There you go, I just materialized this hat out of thin air, just like the characters in the Octonomy. Okay, now I'm just being extra. Anyways, obviously I did enjoy this book, and I would actually highly recommend it to anybody who likes fantasy, who likes Alice in Wonderland, who likes even like a bit of a crime solving as well. This book would be perfect for you. Okay, now that's it. I hope you have enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time, hopefully. All right, bye.